Question number 41. Your company has a Microsoft Office 365 subscription. You need to co-author files with other users. Which tool should you use? Option A, Microsoft SharePoint Online. Option B, Microsoft Skype for Business. Option C, Microsoft Office Delve. Option D, Microsoft Exchange Online. The correct answer is Option A, Microsoft SharePoint Online. Question number 42. A company has a Microsoft 365 subscription. You deploy Windows 10 devices by using Windows Autopilot. You need to ensure that team members can access data that is stored in OneDrive for Business when team members are at remote site. What should you do? Option A, enroll team members in Microsoft Azure AD multi-factor authentication. Option B, add the devices to Microsoft 365 using the devices tile. Option C, enroll devices in Microsoft Intune. Option D, direct team members to sign in into their devices using their Microsoft Azure AD credentials. The correct answer is Option D, direct team members to sign in into their devices using their Microsoft Azure AD credentials. Question number 43. A company has offices in multiple regions. The company has a Microsoft 365 subscription. The company is developing a line of business app. The app must meet the following requirements. Ensure availability regardless of an employee's location. Track the devices on which the app is installed by using Microsoft Cloud Services. Minimize cost. What should you do? Option A, copy the app to Microsoft OneDrive. Allow employees to download and install the app from OneDrive. Option B, deploy the app to all devices using Microsoft Intune. Option C, copy the app to local servers. Allow employees to download and install the app from the server. Option D, deploy the app to all devices by using group policy. The correct answer is Option B, deploy the app to all devices by using Microsoft Intune. Question number 44. What happens when you enable external access by using the Microsoft 365 admin portal? When you enable external access, the correct answer is users can send sharing invitation for specific content. Question number 45. A company has a Microsoft 365 subscription. Employees use personal devices to access company data in the cloud. You need to restrict employees from copying data to personal OneDrive folder. What should you do? Option A, Information Right Management. Option B, Microsoft Azure Security Center. Option C, Microsoft Defender for Office 365. Option D, Microsoft Endpoint Manager. The correct answer is Option D, Microsoft Endpoint Manager. Question number 46. An organization has a Microsoft 365 subscription. You plan to implement multi-factor authentication. For each of the following statement, select yes if the statement is true, otherwise select no. The first statement is, after users are enrolled in multi-factor authentication, they must configure a second authentication factor the next time they sign in. The correct answer is yes. The second statement is, enabling multi-factor authentication requires an additional subscription purchase. The correct answer is no. The third statement is, Complete multi-factor authentication by using text messages, a smartphone app, or a phone call. The correct answer is yes. Question number 47. A company has a Microsoft 365 subscription that includes Office app. A user has identified a new issue while working with an app. When the user attempts to create a support request, the following message displays. You don't have permission to access this page or perform this action. You need to determine the cause of the error message. What is the cause? Option A, the user account is disabled. Option B, the user does not have a license assigned for the app. Option C, the user account is not a member of the global admin role. Option D, the company does not have premier support. The correct answer is option C, the user is not a member of the global admin role. Question number 48. You use Microsoft Business product. When you try to create a support request, you receive the following message. You don't have permission to access this page or perform this action. You need to determine the cause of the error message. What is the cause? Option A, your password is expired. Option B, your account is disabled. Option C, your company does not have premier support. Option D, your account is not a member of the global admin role. The correct answer is option D, your account is not a member of the global admin role. Question number 49. Your company has a Microsoft 365 subscription. You need to implement security policies to ensure that sensitive data is protected. Which tools should you use? On the left side, you have the tools. On the right side, you have the scenario and you need to choose the correct tool. The first scenario is use the Microsoft Authenticator app to enable multi-factor authentication. The correct tool is Identity and Access Management. The second scenario is classify documents to restrict permission to content. The correct tool is Information Rights Management. The third scenario is use a dashboard for data protection recommendation. The correct tool is Compliance Manager. The fourth scenario is provide auditors and regulators with reports on data protection status. The correct tool is Compliance Manager. Question number 50. A company is purchasing a Microsoft 365 subscription to replace the current on-prem IT infrastructure. You need to identify the impact of subscribing to Microsoft 365. Which three outcomes can the company expect? Option A, predictable Microsoft licensing cost. Option B, increased Exchange Server client access license cost. Option C, increased Windows Server client access license cost. Option D, increased service scalability. Option E, decrease on-prem infrastructure maintenance. The correct answers are option A, predictable Microsoft licensing cost. Option D, increase service scalability. Option E, decrease on-prem infrastructure maintenance. Question number